Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the next portion of our theory of machine 2 subject. And currently we are discussing unit number 1, which is nothing but the spur gear. So in last lecture we had seen how to draw the conjugate profile. Now today in this lecture we will see one of the very, very important parameter, that is nothing but the interference in the involute gears. Okay, so that is what we are going to discuss now, interference in the involute gears. Now for this thing, you need to understand this particular diagram, which is nothing but the this diagram we had drawn in the previous lecture. This is nothing but the length of path of contact diagram. Okay, where we will see again what are the different aspects of this particular diagram. Okay, so basically we are having two different gears which are in mesh with each other. This is nothing but the gear 1, which can be called as an pinion. This is nothing but the gear 2, which can be called as an gear wheel. Okay, now this is the minimum radius of an circle, which is nothing but the base circle of an pinion. Then this is what is the pitch circle of an pinion, pitch circle radius of an pinion. Then this is what is the addendum circle of an pinion. Respectively, this is what is the radius of an base circle, this is what is the radius of an pitch circle, and this is what is the radius of an addendum circle of an pinion. So this is what is about what we can say pinion gear. Okay, but when we discussed about the wheel gear, so this is nothing but the base circle of the wheel, this is nothing but the pitch circle of the wheel, and this is what is the addendum circle of the wheel. Okay, on the same line, this is what is the base circle radius, pitch circle radius, and addendum circle radius of the wheel. Now during the initial start of an contact, if this is what is the pinion gear tooth profile, then this will be what wheel gear tooth profile. Okay, and these both gears will be in contact at this particular point, which is nothing but the point K. Are you getting me? So they are starting their meshing or point of contact at the point of point K. Okay, and they will lose their, what we can say, meshing, or they will lose their contact in between both of these two gears at the point of L, which is nothing but this particular point L. Now this is nothing but the intersection point of pitch circle radius of an pinion and pitch circle of an wheel. Okay, and its intersection is known as pitch point. So this is what is the P, is nothing but the pitch point. Are you getting me? So P is pitch point. Now we had seen that KP and PL, so KL is nothing but the, what it is, it is nothing but the length of path of contact. Okay, here we had seen it is nothing but the length of path of contact. On the prior thing, KP is length of path of approach and PL is length of path of recess. Okay, similarly GPH is length of arc of contact. What it is? Length of arc of contact, in which G to P is length of arc of approach, and P to H is arc of recess. Okay, This we have discussed already. Now, today we are about to discuss what exactly interference is and whether it is a desirable property or whether it is an undesirable property in case of meshing. So that is what we are going to discuss. So let's see what exactly interference is. If any portion of the tooth profile which is in contact is not a involute profile. Are you getting me? Which is not the involute profile. Okay. The surfaces in contact will not touch each other tangentially. Okay. So here that tangential touching will not be there at point K. That tangential touching will not be there. Okay. So what it will cause? So causing the improper transmission of motion and power. It will not transfer the motion and power properly. Okay. So in such a case, the relative motion between the tooth surface will not be proper sliding motion. You are aware that whenever we want to transfer motion from one gear to another gear, there has to be a proper sliding motion. Okay, and that particular proper sliding motion will not be there if the type of contact at particular K will not be tangential one. Okay, and thus the transmission of the motion will be rough. As the sliding motion will not be there, so there will be rough transmission of motion will be there. Okay. Mating of two conjugate or two non-involute tooth profile is known as interference. Now, already we had seen different types of profiles. Okay. So conjugate profile is nothing but the which produces the conjugate action. Okay. And what exactly conjugate action is? If we are aware that if the tooth profiles of a gear pair are so designed that the constant angular velocity ratio is produced and it is maintained during the operation, then the gears are said to have the conjugate action. And the tooth profiles which are said to, and the, these kinds of tooth profiles are said to be conjugate profiles. So if two different non-conjugate profiles are in contact with each other, or if two non-involute tooth profiles are in contact with each other, then this is known as interference. Okay, so this is what exactly is the interference. Now let's see further. If an involute can exist only outside the base circle, therefore any profile of the tooth inside the base circle will be non-involute type. If any profile is there which is inside the base circle and if it is non-involute type. Thus, the profile in such a case cannot be tangent to each other. Hence, the tip of the pinion would try to dig out, would try to interfere with the flank portion of the tooth of a gear wheel. Are you getting me? Suppose if this is the particular case, now this is what is the flank portion of an wheel. Are you getting me? And this is what is the tip portion of an pinion. And this is what is the flank portion of an gear. So it will try to dig out some material from this particular point K. It will try to interfere in that particular material. So that is what it is pointing out. Okay. In this case, the tip of the tooth of pinion will undercut the flank portion of the tooth, of the wheel, and it will gradually remove the part of involute profile of the tooth of the wheel. This phenomena is known as interference. Are you getting me? If the tip of any gear tooth is digging out the material from the another teeth, when it will happen? If the contact between these two is not tangential one, okay, at that particular time it will dig out the material from each other, then this kind of phenomena is known as interference. Are you getting me? So that is what exactly is the interference. Let us revise it. Let us understand it more thoroughly what exactly it is. See, the profiles and involute can exist only outside the base circle. Involute has to be there outside the base circle. Huh? Therefore, any profile tooth inside the base circle will be of non-involute type. So if in case any profile is there inside the base circle, it will be non-involute type. Okay. And thus the profile in such a case cannot be tangent to each other. In this particular case, the contact will not be tangent to each other. Are you getting me? So, hence, the tip of the portion of an pinion or wheel would try to dig out or will try to interfere with the flank portion of the tooth of an gear wheel. In this particular case, the tip of the tooth of the pinion will undercut the flank portion of the tooth of the wheel, and gradually it will remove some part of an involute profile of the tooth of the wheel. This particular phenomena is known as interference. Are you getting me? So this is what is the interference. Now, similar will be the case when the addendum radius of the wheel is made greater than O2M. Now, this is what is the O2 and this is what is the M. Okay, now O2K, that is what is the addendum radius of a wheel. Okay, and what it is pointing out is if. Similar will be the case when the addendum radius of the wheel is made greater than O2M. If it is made greater than O2M, so M point is over here. If it is made greater than O2M, the tip of the tooth of the wheel will undercut the flank portion of the tooth of the pinion. Therefore, the point M and are called as interference point. Are you getting me? If this radius RA, if it is greater than the length of O2M, then it will undercut or then it will be digging out the material from the pinion. Are you getting me? Vice versa, same case is there. If this small RA is there, if this length of small RA, if it is made larger than O1N, it will dig out the material from the wheel. Are you getting me? So it is vice versa. It is not limited to this particular case only. It is vice versa. So thus the point M and N are called as an interference point. The condition to avoid interference is that the path of contact KL, now already we had discussed that KL is nothing but the path of contact, isn't it? Should always be less than or equal to the length of MN. Equal to or less than the length of MN. Now from this particular figure, you can easily judge that the length of MN is already less than length of KL. So there won't be a possibility that interference will be there. But in case if it is equal to MN, there also will be the less possibility of an interference. But if KL is greater than MN, we can comment that there won't be a tangential engagement. So there has to be a interference in between these two particular gears. Are you getting me? So this is what exactly is interference is. Okay. So that is what is about the interference. Now, Next thing is undercutting. Okay, so it is quite related with the interference only. Okay, see, let's discuss this. Now, same figure we can refer, or you can refer this particular figure too. Not a problem. If the profile of the tooth below the base circle is non-involute, okay, the profile below this particular base circle is non-involute one. Okay, in this case, the portions of the bill and pinion will not be tangent to each other. As already we had discussed, then the motion will not be tangential to each other, isn't it? And the tip of the bill will dig out or interfere with the flying portion of the pinion. Okay, and it will remove the part of the material. So it will remove the part of the material from the other ear. This is called as an undercut. Okay, and the process of removal of the material is called as an undercutting. Okay, if it is digging out some material from this particular end, then that is what is called as an undercutting. So I hope you are getting this. Let's revise this again. If the profile of the tooth below the base circle is non-involute, in this case, the profile of the bill and the pinion will not be tangent to each other, and the tip of the bill will dig out or interference with the flank of the pinion and will remove the part of the material which is called as an undercut. And the process of removal of the material is called as an undercutting. So this is what is undercutting, which is quite related with the interference. So I hope you have understood this particular thing. That's it for this particular lecture. We will see the next part in the next lecture. From this video, I would like to appeal all of you. If you have any kinds of query, any kinds of suggestions, any points by which we can improve this teaching learning process, so you are always welcome. If you are liking these particular videos, so kindly press the like button, share these videos with your friend circle. Okay, thank you so much. All the best.